Hello and welcome to Soul Stream with Wendy Darling. Today I'd like to just speak a little bit about deliberate creation. You know, we all have a thought that we can dismiss or we can carry. We have words that we speak, and we have a conversation that we have with ourselves. So what I would like to suggest today is that when we have our thoughts, let's try to think about what we want. What we want in our lives, imagine what it looks like, how it feels, how wonderful it is, and speak in that conversation to yourself. What you want in your life, how it feels, how it makes you feel, you know, how it makes others feel, and then take action in your life in positive ways that make you joyful, things that bring you happiness, things that bring happiness to others, gifts that you give that can recreate into something wonderful, to assist in society, with your neighbors and humanity. And I would say this in that there is a possibility that when we are speaking to ourselves with a positive thought and words in our head, that we create this deliberate creation that we speak of. If we speak and we think about negative things and things that we don't want, and we don't want to happen, or that we're angry about, they're not right, and we speak about the things that aren't right, we'll create more of that. So it's very important to try to remember every day to think about what you want to see happen, what you want to create, not what you don't want. And if you remember that, even in our world where we think things are wrong, we can talk about what we'd like to see happen to make it right. So, with deliberate creation, we bring wonderful things. So speak to yourself lovingly and to your neighbors and be kind and create well. Hello, I'd like to welcome my guest today, Vicky Bonington, who is one of the founding members of Burke Chic. And welcome, Vicky.
Thank you.
Burke Chic is a wonderful creation that Nancy Fitzpatrick, Vicky Bonington, and many others, I don't know some of the people who founded.
Well, it was originally Nancy's idea, and she formed a committee, and that's how you and I met. We were on the first Burke Chic committee together.
We met at the Red Lion Inn,
upstairs
in a meeting hall.
Yes, we did, very first time, and we have been involved with Burke Chic ever since. And it was founded in 2012, and we're about to enter into doing the seventh Burke Chic.
Yes, and now Burke Chic is it's a show that happens on, well, this year it's going to happen May 11th through the 13th in West Stockbridge, and we'll tell you more about that. But what it is basically that we ask people to donate their beautiful clothing that they're done with, that they don't wear anymore. We collect it, we tag it, we pull it together, jewelry, clothing, handbags, shoes, men's, women's, children's, some.
No children's.
But we have these beautiful things that come to us, and we have volunteers that help sort through everything, categorize it, make it beautiful, and then we open the doors, and people can come in, and we, first of all, we have a VIP, and that happens
Friday night. The way Burke Chic is structured, it's a three-day event, and Friday night is what we call first dibs night for serious shoppers who are interested in getting in first and seeing what we have collected. And that runs from 5:30 to 8:30 on Friday night, and that is a ticketed event. And then Saturday and Sunday are free, open to the public. Anybody can come and take a look at what we've collected over the course of our time of collecting for Burke Chic. And that's one side of Burke Chic, and we'll get to this later, but the other side of Burke Chic is actually just me. And I bring 14 racks of my own clothing and sell it at Burke Chic, and 100% of the money that's raised on both sides of Burke Chic goes to local nonprofits. It's a fundraiser for many different nonprofits. This year, our principal sponsor is Wham Theater in Pittsfield.
They're wonderful. They do incredible things.
And we'll tell you more about that, too. So,
Yes, and also the VIP ticket, a lot of people like to come in the very beginning because some of the items that they are, and I can attest to Vicky's collection, are phenomenal pieces that you would rarely even get to see, let alone be able to purchase, and to purchase for a great discount and to be able to also give back to community. So it's just a wonderful situation. I would like to say that we have a model, and we're going to have her come and show you. We've got a few things picked out, some casual, some work, you know, some fancy, and I'd like to introduce Wanda to you, and she's just wearing a beautiful sweater from, where do you think that's from, Vicky?
Well, that's actually from my collection.
Okay, this is Vicky's collection.
Yep, and it's just a casual sweater. It's
The sleeves embroidered, are sheer.
The sheer sleeves, and it has long sleeves that you can run over your hands if you want to. It's, you know, some people mm-hmm. like to just shove the sleeves up.
Yeah.
And it's just a very nice casual look.
Beautiful.
It's just an example. We have so much stuff, and we just brought a little smattering.
Just a little bit, yeah.
To give you a taste of the kinds of things that we have at Berk Chic. But as you might guess, we get a different variety every single year because different people donate every year things from their closets. So
right. And there's so many different, you know, you have the very casual, you have the country, the recreational, you have the beautiful evening wear. There's such a vast variety of clothing. It's really wonderful. Thanks, Wanda. We're going to show a couple other things a little bit later, but I'd like to say that the first Berk Chic that ever was happened at the town offices in Stockbridge. And Vicky came in with her collection. And at that point, I brought in my vintage clothing, and other people had brought in some things. There were different vendors happening as well during that time. It was beginning, and we weren't sure exactly how it was all going to shake out. So at this first one, it was really fabulous. We had a fashion show, and we had John Sauer on the piano, and you know, it was just such a great event. Everybody was excited, and it was very successful, and it was a wonderful, wonderful time. And when I saw Vicky and her collection, I thought, who is this woman? She has the most beautiful things I've ever seen. And I asked her, I called her up and I said, I really love your stuff and I really love you. Can we be friends? You know, and that was our first meeting, and we've been friends ever since and have been at every Berk Chic since the first one in, what did you say,
2012, right.
Yeah.
And I had recently retired when Nancy called me and asked if I wanted to be part of this really experiment. It was the first one ever. No one had ever done this before, so it was really an experiment. And just coincidentally, I was done being a lawyer, so I donated to the other side of Berk Chic all of my lawyer clothes, which turned out to be almost 500 items, because I'd been a lawyer for a long time. And it occurred to me then that I still had a lot of other clothes that I could be done with, party clothes and casual clothes and things that wouldn't fit in a courtroom. So that's how my side of Berk Chic started. I brought that first year 5 racks of clothing to sell, with all of the proceeds going to local nonprofits. And so that's how my half of Berk Chic started. And so every year we collect for one side, and I bring stuff for the other side. And it's kind of a good mix because it's a bit yin and yang in the sense that I have on my side a lot of designer pieces and, as Wendy said, one-of-a-kind things that you wouldn't normally see in Berkshire County because I have unusual taste. And the other side is stuff that we collect from people that live here, second homeowners, people that live here year-round, all different kinds. And so every year, Berk Chic is truly a completely different store. So it's worth coming to check it out if you're interested in clothing.
And let's see, I think we have another outfit. Wanda's wearing, oh, this is beautiful. It's a casual work outfit, it could be, or just a casual outfit. Black jeans with a jacket. And let's see that top. That's adorable. Chiffon, polka dot, little blouse. Oh, that's so cute.
Flutter sleeves.
Little flutter sleeves. Very nice. And you could wear that anywhere.
Yes, you could even pair it with like an evening skirt and wear it to a party.
Sure.
It's really cute.
Yeah. So from office to out to have some fun. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Wanda. Yeah, so let's see. The second Berkshik was also in the Stockbridge Town Hall.
Yes, we were in Stockbridge for the first 3 years of Berkshik, and then we kind of outgrew it a little bit. I think we, I don't want to say we wore out our welcome, but we kind of took over the town offices, and that was kind of not fair to the rest of the folks using that space. So we decided we needed a bigger space, and the following year we went to the stationery factory here in Dalton, and boy, we went from 3,000 square feet to 8,000 square feet. So we had 8,000 square feet of space, and I won't say we filled it, but we did a pretty good job.
We did, and that was, it was a beautiful, it was new, that it was not the way it looks today. It was rustic, but it was fabulous. I think that worked so well. We had two huge rooms. One was all Vicky, and the other room was the rest of Berkshik, and it was really successful and wonderful. And what a great place the stationery factory is.
It totally is. And they were so good to us there.
Stephen Sears.
Yes. Thank you, Stephen.
Really
indeed.
Wonderful.
And we had a great time there. And, you know, I should go back and just say, you know, after the first year of Berkshik, we kind of did an evaluation of whether this experiment worked. And it was successful financially, and it did donate money to the nonprofits that were involved with Berkshik. But it's a lot of work. I mean, it takes a lot to schlep all these clothes and get them hung and tagged and steamed and sorted. And, you know, and I said to Nancy at the end of the first Berkshik, you know, Nancy, there has to be an easier way to raise money for local nonprofits than this. And and we were both tired at the time.
Yeah.
And she said to me, yes, that, you know, I'm sure that's true, but wasn't it a lot of fun? Didn't we have a lot of fun? And didn't the people who came have a lot of fun? And she said, and this has always stuck with me, and one of the reasons that I have continued continue to do Berkshik every year, is that there's more to a fundraiser than just the money. It's about building community. It's about what kind of event it is. Is it a fun event? Are people enjoying themselves? Have you added something to the lives of the people who come? And I think we do.
Absolutely.
I think that we've been told so many times that if you come, you will have a wonderful time. And my little tagline for Berkshik is, if you come, I promise you will go home with a treasure. I don't think anyone comes to Berkshik and goes home empty-handed. We have something for everyone.
I totally agree with
that. It's from, you know, from something that's $5 to something that's $1,000. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's a great range of things in there.
And as Vicky said, I mean, it takes a village, literally. We have many people who volunteer, and I'd like to give a nice shout-out to Rebecca Weinman, because she really pulls together so many people and does such a truckload of work getting that together, getting all the clothing sorted and separated. And, you know, there's a lot that goes into it. And you've got to bring everything there. You have to set it all up. You have to tear it all down. But it really matters, because it is something about community. You are giving back. You are working for something better, and working to see people in their joy when somebody finds that treasure.
Yes, it's like a big treasure hunt. It is.
It really, really is.
And I second Wendy's shout out to Rebecca. Rebecca has been essentially the chief operating officer of Berkshik since year one, and has done yeoman's work, and is working right now while we're lolling about here
and
talking.
None of us could do any of it without each other.
Right.
It does take a village. We've really worked hard together, and Rebecca does such hard work, and she's so wonderful. So, Yeah, that's great. Wanda, we got Wanda back again. And she's wearing, this is a beautiful dress, Wanda, that's gorgeous. Isn't this an Amy?
It is. This is an Amy Grubel. Her brand is called Amy G, and that's A-I-M-E-E.
Beautiful.
And Amy and I became friends, I don't know how many years ago.
Love it.
And every year I go to New York and get a bunch of Amy's for the sale. She's my most popular seller. They have no zippers, no buttons. You just pop them on. It's a little bit like wearing a nightgown in terms of comfort. And I love them. A big chunk of my wardrobe is Amy stuff. And
I can see why.
I have many, many customers at Berkshik who come just for Amy. And she's a great designer, I think.
Beautiful.
And She started her career at the Young Designers Market in New York, which is in Nolita in New York. And young designers can rent a booth and basically sell their goods directly to the public.
Oh, nice.
And that's where I met Amy, and we've been friends ever since. So,
well, you know, this is a great outfit because you could wear this to work. Like, she had the little, it's a little cashmere, beautiful little cashmere shawl, sweater. And she could wear that to work, or she could, you know, wear it out.
Right.
I mean, it really... it's very versatile.
Yep, and a lot of Amy's stuff looks great over jeans. I mean, you can, you know, some of them are shorter, and you can wear them over jeans. I think we might have another Amy out there somewhere.
Yes, we do. Thank you.
But as I said, she's, a lot of people come to Berk Chic just for the Amy rack.
Sure, yeah, no, so, I know you bring a lot of her.
Yeah.
And her stuff, it ranges, but like Vicky said, it's very comfortable and great coordination of fabric.
And all washable, too. It's
all
throw it in the washer, and it looks just as good when it comes out as when you threw it in.
Yeah.
So that's a rarity these days.
It is, So, okay, so let's see. We're going to talk a little bit more about Berk Chic. And tell us, Vicky, some of the sponsors that will receive some of the funding.
Well, this year, The way Berk Chic works is that whoever our principal sponsor is, and this year it's Wham Theater, gets all of the money from the side of Berk Chic that is donated. And then my side, I split my donations to four different organizations. And this year it's Wham Theater, the Berkshire Humane Society, Community Access to the Arts, and IS-183, the Art School of the Berkshires.
Oh,
and
wonderful.
They each get 25% of the money that's raised on my side. And I would say, you know, it varies sometimes. Sometimes they do better, sometimes I do better.
Yep.
But together, we usually do pretty well in a weekend.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think last year we raised about $35,000 in the weekend.
That's wonderful.
On both sides. So.
Yeah.
And since we started in 2012, we've donated well over $150,000 to local nonprofits.
Wow.
Just from, you know, folks donating their stuff that they no longer want.
Right.
And, you know, I'm fond of saying that it's a triple win. And when I say that, what I mean is the people who donate win because they are cleaning out their closets and they know that the stuff that they're donating is going to help local community nonprofits, and many of them support all of the organizations that I just mentioned. Then the shoppers win because they're getting a complete bargain when they come in and find their treasure that I promised you were going to get if you came to Berk Chic. You can find, you know, that one, you know, so many people get their Jacob's Pillow gown or they get their gala gown at Berk Chic. I talked to a woman last night, actually, whose daughter bought her wedding dress at Berk Chic for $50. And then the third win is that the nonprofits get the proceeds. 100% of the proceeds go to local nonprofits, and they are very grateful. Most of these, well, almost all of these nonprofits that are our target are not, you know, big, well-funded nonprofits. They add a lot of value to our community, but they're always scrapping for every dollar. So every dollar we give them is really appreciated.
Mm-hmm. And I remember specifically the last Berk Chic event, which was held in Great Barrington.
Yes.
Correct?
Yeah. Yep.
And I remember there were a couple of men who had come in, and very lucky for them, some beautiful men's clothing and shoes was there. And these guys went crazy. You know, for a guy, it's not as easy as it is for a woman. So we really are so grateful for men donating their clothing as well. And, you know, it's just so wonderful to watch people find something they love, see something they love, experience the whole day at Berk Chic. Because what happens is, if you see the VIP, you come in, you get to see everything first. But a lot of people come every day, and
a lot of people do come every day, all 3 days.
Absolutely, and then at the last day, whatever's left, you know, they're excited to find a. Do they give a little bit of a deal?
Yes,
on the last
they
day?
Do. The last day on Sunday, we tend to discount things on the donated side.
Mm-hmm.
I don't donate my half, because, I mean, I don't discount my half because those are my clothes and I actually take them home and wear them.
Yeah. So, or she lets other people wear them sometimes.
Sometimes.
If
you're lucky.
Yeah, if you're very lucky. For instance, this is one of my favorites that Wanda has on. And Vicky knows, one of my favorite designers is Johnny Was.
Yeah.
And this is a Johnny Was silk dress. Phenomenal. Cut on the bias. Just feels like you're wearing nothing, doesn't it? It is so magnificent.
It's a great summer dress. It is.
But the little top that you have on over it is sensational.
Well, that's a Jane Wheeler. She is a knitter, actually, from England, and she's known for her knits. And that is actually a knitted jacket with sequins that have been added that makes you look like a little fairy queen.
Oh, really? That is a fairy princess ball dress if I ever saw one. That is so beautiful.
And I do have quite a lot of Johnny Was. I will be bringing a fair number of Johnny Was dresses if you're interested in Johnny Was.
Where could you ever find something like that? I mean, really, that is just beyond one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. Gorgeous, Vicky.
You look lovely, Wanda.
Yeah. Thank you.
This is from Vicky's collection, and it is just... Her collection is spectacular.
I should mention that everything that we brought today will be available at BerkChic. Mm-hmm. So, we picked things that,
that we know
will be there. So, if you see something you like, come to BerkChic.
Yeah, I want that. So last year was great, and every year has been a phenomenal time. We have moved things around and taken things out and decided to do things differently each time as we've grown. The first year in Stockbridge, we had a lot of food the first year, and we had a fashion show. We had John Sauer on piano, and we had a lot going on. We had a lot going on, and it was maybe a little too much. It was a little too much, a little chaotic.
It wasn't too much for the shoppers. It was too much for us.
Yeah, exactly. The shoppers loved it.
The fashion show in particular is. I mean, we had a lot of work just trying to get the clothes together. So doing a fashion show on top of that was a little bit too much.
Right, trying to pick up everything.
So we're doing a fashion show here for you.
Yeah, exactly. So we decided to do it this way, and this year, BerkChic will be held in West Stockbridge, at the Historical Society, which is on Main Street.
Mm-hmm. Number 9 Main Street. It's the large white building right in the middle of West Stockbridge. And, it's going to be great. Mm-hmm. It's on 2 floors. I'm going to have 1 floor, and the other floor is going to be where Rebecca will have all of the donated items arranged beautifully for your shopping pleasure. Okay. And then our Friday night party will have food from the Red Line Inn and wine donated by Domaney's. And goodie bags and the tickets for Friday night, there's 2 levels of tickets. $25 is the basic ticket, or you can, if you want to help out these local nonprofits and get an extra hour of special shopping, there's a $100 ticket. And what you get for your $100 is 1 hour that's devoted to you. We have people available to help you shop. We have you have the place to yourself for an hour before anyone else can come in. And a lot of people like that because they get, it's called the first dibs party, and so you get first dibs.
And that starts on Friday, what time?
5:30 is the first hour, and then $25 tickets come in at 6:30, and we stay until 8:30, or, it tends to run late. People tend to not want to go home afterwards.
Yeah.
And everyone that buys a ticket gets a goodie bag, which has at least $25 worth of stuff in it. It's got some Jane Iredale makeup, and it's got some stuff from Annie Selke, who I should mention Annie is one of our sponsors this year. She's helping defray some of the costs of putting on BerkChic. So, I think if you come on Friday night, I'm fond of saying Friday night's when all the action is.
It is fabulous.
Yeah.
It's really fabulous time. And then, it's on Saturday and Sunday as well, and I believe Saturday is 10 to 4,
and Sunday is 10 to 2. Mm-hmm. So,
and it's free on those 2 days. So it really, it's a win for all the people that will receive, and it's a win for the people that come and find their treasures. And we have another little fairy outfit that Wanda's going to wear. I love this one, too. I love the sparkle, I got to admit. Oh, that's gorgeous. Oh, my God, look at that. That is a silk skirt, all hand-dyed and beautifully sequined with another, is that
another Jane Wheeler.
Jane Wheeler, yep. Look at, oh my God.
Yeah, Jane Wheeler's little notch in the back is kind of her signature, and that is a cashmere shrug.
Oh, gorgeous.
And I think Wanda will attest that it's incredibly soft.
So soft.
Yeah,
beautiful.
It's like if you're a person that can never wear a sweater because you're allergic to wool, Jane Wheeler is your answer. Her cashmere is some of the best. And it just looks great. It really does. And it's, you know, it's, again, it can be casual. It can be dressy depending on how you, what you pair with it,
right,
in terms of shoes, right, or top.
Well, that looks fabulous. That little top with that skirt is amazing. Do a spin for us. Let's see. I love it. Beautiful. Thank you, Wanda. That's so cute. Oh, I love how that the light hits those sequins. That's beautiful. Beautiful work. And these are really treasures. These are things you cannot find. I mean, this is Vicky digs and she looks for things and finds the most beautiful things that she brings into her collection. That's why coming to just even to see her stuff beyond all the other wonderful clothes is such a gift, because things you would never see.
I should also mention that a lot of people who know me say, oh, well, you wouldn't have anything that would fit me. Mm-hmm. And I should mention that my weight goes up and down substantially. And I have, in my side of the equation, size 2 to size 16.
Yeah.
So there will be something that will fit you if you decide that you want to have a look on my side of the fence.
Mm-hmm.
Because
yeah,
I have every size known to man. So there is something that you will find that will fit you. And not everything on my side. This is a misnomer, too, that my side has $20 racks.
Right.
$40 racks. It's not all super expensive. Although I do have a couple of racks that I call the priceless rack.
Which is something I love.
It's the stuff that is truly priceless. It's mostly one-of-a-kind stuff that you won't see here in Berkshire County very often. Dries Van Noten and Yoshi Yamamoto and Issey Miyake and Martin Margiela and many esoteric designers that you would not otherwise see locally. And if you're interested in, like, Anne de Moulemeester or any of the Belgian designers or any of the Japanese designers, I've got them. So it's, and I'm, you know, there's always stuff on my racks from, you know, really sort of hard-to-find, interesting designers. So if you're interested in one-of-a-kind kind of things, you should come have a look. And, you know, I'm willing to part with some of them.
Yeah.
And so I put them on the priceless rack, and in order to buy something on the priceless rack, you
have to negotiate with
you. Have
Vicky.
To have a discussion with me. Mm-hmm. I want to make sure it's going to a good home.
Right.
So.
And that's the way she is with her clothing. She loves her clothing, and she wants to see other people joyous and be able to have something.
It is true. Yeah. I really do enjoy when someone finds something they love. It really makes me happy, and I'm glad it's going home with somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So
I have been fortunate enough to partake in a few things that Vicky has brought in that have, I can't tell you the joy that they brought me in my life when I wear them, and everybody's like, that's so beautiful, and I just, you know, feel like $1 million in it, and it makes me happy. You know, let's face it, life can be very intense. We have the good and the bad and the roles that go up and down, but let's really make sure that we all have a little joy in our lives from something that really matters to us. And even if it's looking good to go somewhere, or it may seem frivolous, but those things are important, because we need things in our life to lift us, and that lifts others, and then it just sends out a wave. And in my life, I believe it's all about the love. It doesn't matter what the love is all about. Clothing, in this case, friendships, you know. It's a wonderful thing.
Well, there's a funny story about that, in that the question that I get a lot at Berkshire is, I love this, but where am I going to wear it? And my answer always is, how about your living room?
Yeah.
I mean, if you try something on and it makes you feel great and you just think you look like $1 million in it, you should have it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care if you ever wear it anywhere.
Yeah.
And I was telling someone this story, and I said, you know, when I'm having a bad day, I go pull 10 great dresses and go try them on and look and say, this looks pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And the person I was speaking to said, oh, when I'm having a bad day, the last thing I want to do is try on clothes. I said, then you have the wrong clothes. You need to find something that makes you feel great, and you should have that. Even if it's, you have one great jacket or one great dress, whatever it is, you know. I do recognize that not everyone, clothes is not the thing for everyone. Maybe it's you have one great car, or you have one, whatever it is,
whatever
that
it is,
floats your boat. But you should indulge yourself every now and again in something that makes you feel terrific.
Yeah, I've always said, you know, I've always liked clothing. I've always made my own clothes. I became a designer. But I always felt like I would go to the grocery store in whatever I was wearing. And it didn't matter where I was going. I was going to dress the way I wanted to. And it made me feel good. So it didn't matter. I just love that. Wanda, she's got something else on. Let's see. Oh, that's cute. Now that looks like that could be casual.
That could be a beach dress.
Yes.
Or you could dress it up with glittery shoes and a little glittery shawl and wear it to a party.
Let's see that.
That is a Jean-Paul Gaultier.
Oh,
with
beautiful.
A little jacket. Yeah. And
it's got a little knit bodice.
Yes.
And cotton.
It's his, the top is his, you know, if you know Gaultier, you know his fabric, which is kind of a mesh nylon, the top. And this is paired with a cotton bottom. And like I said, it wraps, it's so it's adjustable size-wise, and it is a great beach dress. You can put flip-flops with that and go anywhere.
And I'm meaning that this dress that Wanda has on right now, I think it's a large, if I'm not mistaken, and she is
anything
but a
size,
large.
Size 2.
Yeah, so you can see, and she's just got it wrapped, you know, and it looks great. So, and Gaultier is one of those designers, too, where you can really...
Right.
You know,
and as I mentioned earlier, because my size goes up and down all the time, I have a lot of clothing that is adjustable for whatever size you are, because I never know what size I'm going to be.
Yeah, exactly. So. Well, that was really cute. I mean, like you could see that could be a great beach dress, and then she puts that little shrug on, and you could go out.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a great dress, especially for traveling. Like, it doesn't wrinkle very much. You can roll it up in a ball.
Yeah.
You have it. You can... wear it during the day. If you're at the beach, you can wear it out to dinner. It's it's really a versatile dress.
I'd like to say that I actually brought the clothes here in a blue bag. So, and I didn't steam them. I didn't do anything except take them out of the bag and hang them up. So you could see that they all look pretty good.
Yeah.
You know.
Most of my stuff is pretty, you know, no fuss, no muss.
Yeah. Also, Vicky, I got to say, she has these incredible costumes as well as her beautiful collection. And IS-183 does a lot of special events where they have, what was one, Bollywood?
Yes, it was the Buckaroo Bollywood
Buckaroo
Ball.
Bollywood Ball.
Yeah, there are, I should mention that's coming up, by the way. The IS-183 party is the weekend after Berkshire. It's called Camp Kitschy Kinky, and it will be at Eisner Camp in Great Barrington. And we did a photo shoot, and those pictures are up on Facebook right now. If you go to the IS-183 page on Facebook, you'll see them, including me and my family. And I will have that rack of clothing. I promised IS-183 I would have that rack of clothing from the photo shoot at Berkshire. So if you're looking for a costume for Camp Kitschy Kinky, you can come to Berkshire, and I will help you get dressed.
Great. And don't they, on the IS-183 site, do they have past, can you see Buckaroo Bollywood, can you see any past events?
I don't think so. Don't think you can. Although, if you look at my Facebook page, you will see many, many, many costumes.
That's worth a look. I'll tell you, she was Kali, and she has just worn the costume. She, you know, one was all flowers, and one was all little...
Tchotchkes.
Right. Just incredible. Her costumes are incredible. One where you were you a cyborg or?
A Borg,
yeah. I mean, incredible things. Worked with artists to create something really special. So it's, you know, definitely check it out. It's amazing. And like she said, she'll have that rack of clothes.
And if you're stymied for, you know, the IS-183 party, please do come. We'll help you find something that you think will be fun. The theme, Camp Kitschy Kinky, is about camping or Boy Scouts or Girl Scouts or John Waters campy or anything that you interpret it as. So it's
fun. Those things, we have a dance.
Yes, it's a dinner and a dance,
and
it will be at, and all the details are on the IS-183 website. I should also mention that we have a Berkshire website that will answer any questions that you have, because I put in a frequently asked questions section.
Right.
So if you do have a question that's not answered, please contact me because I will answer your question on the website. And I'll answer it on the phone too.
Yeah.
The website is Berkshik, BerkShique.com. BerkShique.com.
And also on the website, if you feel like you want to volunteer or if you would like to donate things, please check out the website and get in touch with Rebecca.
Yeah,
and
there's a form on the website to be in touch with Rebecca, and Rebecca's telephone number and my telephone number. So,
because every little bit helps, and it just makes it all that much more fun. And, you know, it's just a great event, and we really hope that you get involved in whatever way you wish, just to shop or to help or to donate. Wanda, okay, this is another one of my very favorite outfits, I must say. This is amazing. Oh, my gosh. Look at that.
This is a Kenzo duster, which can be worn as a coat. The necklace that Wanda is wearing is actually the belt that came with this outfit. And underneath, she is wearing a Jean-Paul Gaultier crocheted dress, which is a work of art in my humble view. It's really a gorgeous dress. It's asymmetrical sleeves. It's really just a great, great dress. And it will fit a variety of sizes.
Cut on the bias.
Yeah, it's cut on the bias. Yes, yep. It's really quite a piece. And the Kenzo coat is by Antonio Morris, who is a designer for Kenzo. And his pieces are very sought after and very difficult to find. And I should mention both of those pieces are from my collection, and
probably
both of
priceless.
Them. Yes, they're on the priceless list, but they've never been worn. They're both brand new. So
I wonder if I could take my life savings out for the jacket.
Well, some of the stuff on the priceless list is pretty pricey, but it's much cheaper than it would be if you tried to buy it, you know, anywhere else.
That is, what a spectacular piece.
Yeah, it's awesome. I couldn't resist. I that's a sentence I utter a lot, isn't it?
Yes,
couldn't resist.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to not have to resist all the time. Sometimes we have to, but when we can just splurge a little bit, bring something special, you know, it's just...
Well, it's interesting because I do have a lot of clothing, which is why I'm able to bring a lot of things to sell at Berkshik. But I kind of see my clothing collection like some people see a scrapbook. Mm-hmm. I said, you know, if I was ever going to open a real store and not just a pop-up store, I would call it Every Garment Tells a Story, Don't It? Because every garment does tell a story.
Yeah.
I mean, I can tell you pretty much
where
every
you went,
garment.
How you found it.
Exactly. Where it came from, where I wore it, if I did wear it, you know, what my plan for it was, mm-hmm. what, you know. I have a story about pretty much every garment that
passion.
I have.
It is. Passionate.
It's just I find it. I just find it interesting. And there's a story. You know, Rural Intelligence has done a couple of stories about Berkshik in Rural Intelligence. I do admire great design. I do admire innovation. I do admire young designers who are just starting out and trying their wings, like Amy. You know, I'm going to Paradise City and when it's here in Northampton because there's a designer there who used to sell in Nolita at the Young Designers Market, who's still around and still selling things, and I love her stuff. And she's not very famous, but I just want to go and see what she's up to these days.
And it's the story.
Yes, it's the story.
I
find it interesting. I'm not sure everyone would, but... You know, it's like if you have an interest in clothing, you know, I think I have some interesting stories to tell you. So come by.
Great. Oh, and here we go. This is our last piece. And this is a Jean-Paul Gaultier.
Yes.
And it's an evening gown, but it's a very casual evening gown that could be worn.
Again, could be a beach dress for sure.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little longer. It's longer in the back, as you can see.
Beautiful.
It's actually intended for someone a little bit taller than Wanda, but it looks great on Wanda nonetheless.
Yeah.
And she's paired it today with a curly lamb vest, which
beautiful.
Is made by Bird, which is the high-end brand of actually Juicy Couture.
Beautiful.
And You know, so you could wear that to any kind of black tie mm-hmm. party, for mm-hmm. sure.
Gala.
And but you could go right from the beach, actually. Just put your
exactly.
put your little shruggy thing on
yeah.
and off you go.
From your
change
sandals
your shoes.
To your heels?
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
And it is the yep. Jean-Paul Gaultier mesh fabric again. It's a nylon mesh. It's completely washable. It is completely not wrinkle. You can't wrinkle
yep.
that stuff.
Yep.
And it's washable.
Though, and even though it's a little long in the back, it just trails beautifully.
Yeah.
It just trails beautifully. And while it's very little, so, you know, it could, you, again, go, you know, the size can go
yes,
like
that dress,
a,
I should,
two to an eight,
can you
ten,
show
maybe.
Wanda that it's a wraparound? It's
yeah.
a, it just ties.
Yep.
So it's completely
it
adjustable
mm-hmm.
To how big, small your waist is, how big, small your hips are. You yep. know, it basically would fit a multitude of sizes. So
beautiful.
as many of my clothes will, because I am often a multitude of sizes. So
thank you, Wanda, so much. It's gorgeous. Look at the float on that. That is beautiful. And you feel like $1 million bucks.
Yes.
Something like that. And yeah. comfortable.
Yes, it's very so. Comfortable. It has no zippers, no buttons, no nothing. It's just mm-hmm. a wrap.
Well, and this is a wrap. We're about to say goodbye, and we would really like to encourage you to go to the website, www.berkchic.com, and see what's available, and if you would like to donate, if you'd like to volunteer, or if you just want to come, we'd love to see you. We'll be there. And we'll be having fun all weekend, May 11th through the 13th. And all the details are on the website. And we thank you for being with us today and joining us for this little fun conversation. And thank you, Vicki.
Thank you.
Very much. And all the people that work so hard, tirelessly, to pull Berkchic together and to make it disappear at the end. And all the funding that goes to these great organizations. It's really a blessing, and thank you very much. And create well. Create well.